Our training project will have three stories: the existing ground floor on which we've already worked, a foundation, and an upper gallery that we'll create now. Open the Design Story Settings dialog box. By default, ArchiCAD creates the project with three stories. Select the third story, number 2, and name it Roof. Let's rename the first story to Gallery and enter 3 meters as the elevation height, and leave Height to Next at 3.20. With the ground floor item selected, click the Insert Below button to insert a new story below the existing ground floor. Type Foundation and enter -1 as elevation. Click OK. Please note, you can easily navigate between stories by simply double-clicking the relevant story under the Stories folder of the Navigator project map. Let's add now a semi-pitched roof to the building with wide overhangs supported by the columns to create a south-facing veranda at the front. Open the One Gallery story. Activate the Roof tool in the toolbox and adjust its settings as follows. Pivot Height, Pivot Line Offset to Home Story 1.0 meters. Cut Composite Fill, Roof, Aluminum. Select the Single Plane Geometry method. Set an angle of 18 degrees. Set perpendicular edges for the roof's edges. Top material, metal sheet corrugated, side and bottom, wood pine horizontal. Tags, load bearing element, exterior, roof. Layer, shell, roof. Click OK. First, create a guideline parallel to the upper exterior wall by 0.55 meters. Then start to construct a pitched roof by defining its pivot line by clicking on the internal corners of the lower x-directional exterior wall. Define the direction of the slope by clicking above the previously defined pivot line with the eye-shaped cursor. Draw the perimeter of the roof, which is its projection to the horizontal plane, using the lines of the site plan drawing and the newly created guideline. Activate the 3D window view in the Navigator. You can see that the tops of the walls are not fully aligned to the roof. Now we will trim them to the right height. Select the walls by shift-clicking on one of them. The walls are grouped, so if you have suspend groups off, which is a default setting in the standard toolbar, one selection will select all 4 wood exterior walls. Right-click and select Connect. Trim elements to roof or shell. Click anywhere on the roof. The empty roof icon turns black if the program finds a selectable element. Click the side of the walls you want to keep. The chosen side is highlighted in blue before clicking. The only problem is that if we select the walls, we can see that it's intersecting with the roof. To solve this, we have to change the priority of the roof skin. Select the roof and open Options, Element Attributes, Building Materials, and set the priority of Air Space Frame to 735 to make it higher than the structural masonry and all other materials used within the wall composite. This building material is the bottom layer of the roof composite. Click OK when done. The walls are now associatively trimmed to the roof. If you change the roof geometry or sloping angle, the walls will be updated automatically. Please note, later on you can review and manage the connections between the elements very easily. If you select an element which has connections, an icon appears on its surface. Click on the icon to get a list of current connections. You can highlight the intended elements as well as delete the connections together or one by one.